Namaste viewers. Today we will be talking about social marketing and its implications on public health management. To take this discussion forward, we have with us Dr. Kirti Uday, who is an expert in this area. She works as assistant professor in FMS-WISDOM, Banasthali Vidyapith. So ma'am, could you start us off by telling what is the meaning of social marketing? For a common man, what does this imply?
Sure. So first of all, I would like to present my thank you to the team who have given me this opportunity. So as you have asked, what is social marketing? So as you all are aware, first of all, what is marketing? When we talk about marketing, marketing means understanding who is my customer, which is like segmentation, targeting, and then position the product, and then finally understand the pricing, place and promotion aspect. The same way, when we talk about social marketing, when the concept of social marketing is applicable in the social welfare, means addressing the social issues, then it is called social marketing. These days we are talking a lot about no plastic use. We have also talked about pulse polio campaign, and we were successful in eradicating it from India. So ultimately, how all these things are possible, and we are in the process of making all these things possible, that is with the help of social marketing, where we try to create awareness, educate the target audience and influence their behavior in a positive way. So this is all about what social marketing is.
I see. So could you tell me the difference between commercial marketing and social marketing? How different is it?
Sure. So when we talk about commercial marketing and social marketing, as came from the definition, the concepts remain same, but there is one dissimilarity, and the dissimilarity lies in the objective. Okay. When we talk about commercial marketing, the objective is business growth. We want to earn profit with the help of marketing activity. But when we talk about social marketing, then the objective is to influence the target audience behavior. So I would like to give one example. For example, we would like to improve the hand washing practices among children and students. So in that case, we want them that they should wash the hand at the right time. For example, after defecation, after cleaning child feces, after eating food, before eating food and so on. And also they should wash the hand with soap and in a right way. So improve, how will you improve all these things? So you have to create the awareness, you have to educate the student,
yes,
and that too in a different way, by using creative marketing. So that is something social marketing. The applications remain the same as I mentioned, but the difference is social welfare, addressing social issues which influence the positive behavior of the target audience.
So what would be the marketing mix of social marketing as compared with commercial marketing?
Sure, it's a very valid question, ma'am. As you all are aware, that what are the four most common P's of marketing? The four most common P's of marketing are product, price, place and promotion.
Yes.
The same thing in case of social marketing, but still there is a difference. So what is the difference? When we talk about product in case of social marketing, so if it is a tangible product, then we promote contraceptive. We promote use of ORS and zinc for the treatment, diarrhea treatment specifically. On the other hand, when we talk about services, then environmental protection, improving infant feeding practices, improving hand washing practices, all those comes under the services of social marketing, which is considered under the first P of social marketing, that is product.
Okay.
When we talk about the second P, that is price. So price is not something always monetarily, but price is something what customer pay to receive the product.
Okay.
So if he is paying time to give vaccination to the children, that time is also considered price under the social marketing. The third P of marketing mix, place. So if it is again a tangible product, then the distribution channel, that how contraceptives are reaching to household, that is called place. And when it comes to services, then in that case the channel which is used to spread the messages, through which the messages are reaching to the target audience, that is called place. The fourth is promotion, which is very important. And promotion is something using of mass media and various promotional tools like counseling, advertisement, loudspeaker announcement. There are many promotional tools which we will discuss further. So those things when applied to create awareness with the help of some communication activity that implies promotion under social marketing. In addition to 4 P's, that is product, price, place and promotion, 3 more important P's plays important role. The next one is people. People means the target audience. We make social marketing program to influence the behavior of whom? Of the target audience. So that target audience are called people, because ultimately the objective of social marketing is to influence behavior of target audience.
Yes.
When we talk about purse setting, so in social issues we need funds. Without funds you cannot sustain the program for a longer period of time. Considering this, purse setting, that is generating revenue and funds to sustain and scale the program further, we use this piece. And the last is policy. Now again, the program will not be implemented on a larger scale and it cannot be successful till the time the policy is implemented, is drafted from the government level, from the state level, from central level and from the local bodies as well. So in the same way, policies plays important role. So by considering this thing, I will say product, price, place, promotion, people, purse string and policy. These are the important pieces of social marketing which has to be considered while implementation of any social marketing program.
So that's a very interesting input, ma'am. But what I would like to know further is, what is your criteria for the selection of any social marketing program? How do you select what you are going to market?
Yes. See, it's a very common challenge. There are a lot of programs, public health programs running in India, right from No Plastic Use Once Again, which is the very recent one, to Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, to Diarrhea Control, to HIV Prevention and many things.
Yes.
So the question exists, is every program is a social marketing? The answer is no. Every program cannot be considered as social marketing. So for that, Edrisens, one of the very renowned scientists, laid down the social marketing benchmark criteria. So this social marketing benchmark criteria, if it is applicable in the program, then we consider that program as a social marketing intervention. If these criteria are not mentioned, are not included, then in that case it is not a social marketing program. So what are those benchmark criteria? The first benchmark criteria talks about behavior change. If the objective of the program is to influence the behavior of the target audience, then it is considered as the first criteria.
Okay.
The second criteria talks about audience research. Means before implementation of the program, you understand your target audience, the consumer behavior, and then designing of the intervention. The third criteria talks about exchange. There is some motivational exchange for the target audience. The fourth criteria talks about marketing mix. Means there is an implementation of product, price, place and promotional activities together to meet the program objective.
Mm-hmm.
The next criteria talks about competition. It means there are certain behavior or there are certain drives which stop the influence or the desired behavior. So those drives, those factors has to be minimized,
mm-hmm.
which is considered as competition. And the last criteria talks about segmentation and targeting. So I would like to take one example briefing about segmentation and marketing, mm-hmm. Targeting. That if you are targeting children in a school or children in household,
mm-hmm.
it's a two different segment.
Yes.
School versus household.
Yes.
Within the school, I may target girl child or I may target boy child, depending on the program. This is called targeting.
Okay.
So this segmentation and targeting also has to be considered while talking about the social marketing program. So if minimum 2, maximum all 6, when all these criteria are available in a particular program, then that program is considered as a social marketing program or social marketing intervention, which differentiate it from other programs. And many review of literature, many literature from published in various journals, which has proved and which has also many researchers has applied this Edrisens benchmark criteria for the identification of social marketing program.
So keeping this criteria in mind, could you just walk me through the process of social marketing? How do we go about it?
Yeah, so process again, since we are talking about public health management and that to social marketing. Mm-hmm. So the concept of management and marketing remains the same. And when we talk about social marketing process, then the first process starts with strategic planning. So, like, what is my program objective? Mm-hmm. Which social issues I would like to address? Then, who is the target audience? Mm-hmm. What is the objective of my program?
Okay.
All these things have to be considered first under the phase of strategic planning.
Okay.
After this, in the second step, you have to select the right channel and the right material. So, when you talk about right channel and right material, how I am going to share the message and what are the materials, whether it will be poster, it will be hoarding, loudspeaker announcement, mm-hmm. or a direct one-to-one counseling. So, what is the channel
I see.
Then what is the material you will use?
Okay.
Then in the third phase, before execution, you should test the material.
Okay.
So these materials are tested among the small group of target audience. The fourth phase includes the execution of the program as decided under the strategic planning. Mm-hmm. Then it leads to assessment, evaluation of the program as per the objective which is decided in the case of strategic planning phase. And finally, reviewing based on the evaluation, you can further redefine the communication materials and other aspects so that you can further improve the social marketing program. So this is how the process goes on, and very commonly it is also called the social marketing wheel.
The social marketing wheel, that's yeah. Very interesting. You spoke about evaluation. How do you evaluate a social marketing program, whether it is effective, not effective? What are your measures?
When we talk about evaluation, so as I said, it is one of the part of social marketing process, mm-hmm. that is assessment, mm-hmm. and on the basis of assessment, you can further redefine the communication and the other marketing mix strategy.
Okay.
So when we talk about evaluation, there are four types of social marketing evaluation.
Mm-hmm.
So one is called formative, second is process, third is outcome, and the fourth is impact evaluation. So when we talk about formative evaluation, it is before the execution phase. So for example, if I am testing the communication material, mm-hmm. if I am conducting a market research to understand the consumer behavior,
okay.
all those comes under formative evaluation. When I am evaluating the process of execution, that talks about the process evaluation, whether everything is executed as per the planned activity. When we measure the immediate result,
mm-hmm.
that comes under the outcome evaluation. It means I am assessing that whether I am on the way or in terms of reaching the right target or not as per the objective. And the final, which is the long term, which gives the long term impact, that is called impact evaluation. So where we actually evaluate that what is the program objective and whether it is successful enough to reach the desired change in behavior. So basically it's a long term result. To differentiate between the outcome evaluation and impact evaluation looks almost similar.
Okay.
But when we talk about impact evaluation, it is something a long term result. And when we talk about outcome evaluation, it is based on the short term objective and to measure that whether whatever I have implemented, mm-hmm. it is giving the desired result or not. So that is outcome evaluation.
Okay. So if we take the area of public health management, what models of social marketing would you apply there?
See, when we talk about the public health model,
mm-hmm.
and that too in terms of social marketing and health communication,
mm-hmm.
there are a lot of model, and in fact scientists are working day on and day in about it, and it is like we are developing a lot of model on a continuous basis.
Okay.
But I would like to highlight 2-3 model, which is something started from the beginning and which is like a base model which every scientist consider while designing the social marketing intervention. So the one of the model which is very commonly and the first model, which is called health belief model.
Okay.
So when we talk about health belief model, it is a common understanding that behavior can only be influenced if the target audience consider the vulnerability of the issue.
Okay.
So for example, these days we are talking about no plastic use. The government is promoting on a larger scale, but actually target audience are not using the plastic.
Mm-hmm.
Some were yes, some were no.
Okay.
So when we analyze ourselves that yes, it is an important environmental issues and it has to be stopped right away.
Mm-hmm.
The self-belief of the individual, that is something called health belief model.
Okay.
So under this model, we influence to generate the belief factor among the target audience so that they themselves become responsible for the activity. Then we talk about the second model, which is a very commonly called knowledge attitude behavior model. So when we talk about knowledge attitude and behavior model, so in this phase the social marketing drives actually help to build the knowledge first, which will influence your attitude, and finally that will change your behavior. So there is a one common understanding about the behavior which is said in the model, that if behavior is punished, then in that case the behavior will not be repeated.
Okay.
But on the other hand, if the behavior is motivated, rewarded, appreciated, then the target audience believes to repeat the behavior. So this is like in a very short way I would like to explain knowledge attitude and behavior model. One more model I would like to explain, which is again when we are talking about marketing, then communication is important.
Mm-hmm.
And this is called communication model. So under this model we use the principle of segmentation, targeting, positioning and messaging. So we understand who is the target audience, what I am trying to achieve from those target audience, where is the gap, where I positioned myself among the target audience, and finally depending on the target audience we design the messages. So STP leads to message decision, message designing,
mm-hmm.
and message implementation. So this is called communication model. So there are many, but these are the three important models we consider in public health management to influence the behavior under social marketing.
So what about the applications of these models? How do you know what model we are going to apply in social marketing?
Social marketing is applicable in various domains of public health.
Okay.
So first of all, here I would like to highlight few issues related to what is public health and that to public health management.
Mm-hmm.
So when we talk about public health management, so we deal with various public health issues. So one side, let's say talk about our country.
Mm-hmm.
So we are dealing with HIV prevention, we are dealing with obesity,
mm-hmm.
we are dealing with mental health issues.
Yes.
And on the other side we are also dealing with common disease like diarrhea, malaria, obesity, which I have already explained, and cholesterol management,
mm-hmm.
hypertension and many aspects. So this social marketing activities is applicable in all the domain of public health management, and many literature which I have shared in my written content as well, many literature has been used talking about the intervention, the application of social marketing intervention in public health management, and all the literature almost shown that there is an improvement in the social issues, in the public health issues, when the social marketing intervention is applied. And the most important method which we actually used was the case control method, study approach.
Okay.
So basically in this method the researchers tried to include the intervention in one group and the other group is without the intervention. So by evaluating the case in control, you can evaluate and assess that whether the intervention is working or not. So these are like one of the common evaluating parameters using the case control method approach. But this is something, a very broad topic, difficult to conclude in a small talk. But yes, I would like to conclude in a way when we talk about the public health management,
mm-hmm.
that social marketing internationally, nationally, applicable in all the aspects of public health management, right from communicable to non-communicable to lifestyle management and even the mental issues as well.
Okay. So could you tell me what some of the challenges are in social marketing when we come across campaigns like this? What are certain challenges that a person could face?
Sure. See, every side has a two coin, and same in terms of challenges with social marketing.
Mm-hmm.
So one common challenge is, even the program is successful and there is a desired change, you cannot claim that is because of social marketing.
Okay.
Because the causality is an issue, because at a point there are more than one programs runs in that area. So you cannot claim that that successfulness or that achievement is exclusively the impact of social marketing. So that measurement, that evaluation factor is one of the challenge. There are many more challenges as well. The second is when we talk about sustainability.
Mm-hmm.
Till the time program is implemented, social marketing program, it is okay. But after the completion of the program, whether the behavior is sustainable among the target audience, that sustainability is the another concern. When we achieve some result, then we always want to scale it up further so that the program is taken at a broader level and influence the larger part of the society. So scalability is the another challenge, that with the whatever changes happen, the desired result created because of the social marketing intervention. So whether that will be applicable and scalable in the other part of the country and other part of the health issues. So that another challenge of social marketing. Apart from that, marketing is a very much commercial subject.
Yes.
So to actually apply marketing into addressing the social issues and the acceptability of that factor, mm-hmm. which is something called critical marketing. So that's another issue, because people understand marketing as something else. But we also, in practicality, we use marketing to address social issues. The another is you have to change individual behavior,
mm-hmm.
but it has to lead to change the community behavior. So actually how a social marketing activities leads to conversion of individual behavior to commercial and the community behavior, that is also a concern, and this has to be addressed on a larger scale. And then finally, when we address the social issues, then by addressing these kind of social issues, the topic emerges like equity,
mm-hmm.
non-gender biasness,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of things. So those things also has to be considered while talking about the social marketing. So these are the challenges. I will say, though it's a challenge, but there is a solution for every problem. So these points has to be considered while designing the social marketing program. And if it is considered well, considering these point and the theoretical aspect of social marketing, then in my opinion, the issues can be handled very well.
So it's a huge concept, social marketing. Could you also just enlighten us towards the end of our talk how this concept could be applied in a country like India?
Yes. So as you all are aware, social marketing is more applicable in international scenario. There are a lot of institute focusing on this area, working in the area of social marketing, and many global organization, right from WHO, UNICEF, USAID, UNO, they are working with the help of social marketing to address the public health issues. When it comes to India, as I mentioned in the challenge, it is difficult for the people to accept the concept of marketing. So that is something, a common myth. What is marketing? Why it will be used in the social management area like public health? So these are like myth which has to be tackled first. If the myth taken care of, then in that case, I think the implementation of social marketing is not difficult. Because in country like India, we are working on the public health management,
mm-hmm.
and we are using activities like IEC material, information, education and communication material. We also design the program keeping in mind to influence the behavior of the target audience. So more or less, we are working in the line of social marketing, but in tits and bits pieces. This has to be implemented in an integrated form and to present as a topic called social marketing. So regarding this, many international and national organizations are working towards this area, and I definitely hope in the future that social marketing drives programs achieved on a larger scale to solve public health issues in India.
Thank you so much, Dr. Kirti ma'am. That was a very enlightening talk, and I'm sure our viewers will benefit from this. Thank you.
Thank you.